A woman working at a Fort Myers daycare is accused of hitting a five-year-old boy with a belt. The child went to Redeemer Early Learning Center on Winkler Avenue. The Department of Children and Families started investigating last month after the boy showed his father the bruises. NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis is live at the daycare.
Not only is this location under investigation, but also their licensing in question as part of the investigation from DCF after that child told his father that someone actually, a staff member here who is also his mother's girlfriend, took him to the bathroom and beat him with a belt.
He got a whooping from his parent, Jatia Jones.
An investigator with the Department of Children and Families took the witness stand describing what she called significant bruising.
Jatia Jones, whom he refers to as his parent, had punished him at the daycare.
The victim's father asking the judge for a protective order for the child to keep Jatia Jones away from the boy.
He indicated that she punishes him often.
Jones and the boy's mother worked at the Redeemer Early Learning Center. The five-year-old was in the couple's classroom. In the civil case, a judge saw a video connected to the incident.
Jatia will take Jacoby into the bathroom and shut the door while Iris, the mother, will stand at the classroom door watching.
At the child care center, a DCF investigation began, looking into the incident and their licensing. Jones denies hitting the child.
I don't think he's telling the truth.
Even getting emotional about her relationship with the boy.
Everything that he basically knows, I taught him. Because I stay home every day with this kid. I did everything.
A representative for the center says no other child is at risk now. The women were fired and the center is working to remedy the issue. Jones points the finger to the child's mother.
I didn't think it was abuse.
Not all parents out here at this child care center agree with the termination of those women. I did ask the vice pastor if he believes that there are any other incidents under investigation connected to the two that were fired. He says, not to his knowledge. I reached out to local law enforcement. They say they cannot tell me if there is any active investigation or pending criminal charges at this time. Reporting live in Fort Myers, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.